The system is broken, and the question is, how do we fix it? So last week, Euro Dressage posted an article talking about Inessa Merkulova. Now, this season on Dressage Hub, we've talked about bias judging, some of the corruption behind the scenes, and now we are addressing it in the other half of the world. So here we go. Last week, Euro Dressage addressed the topic that Inessa Merkulova did this ride with an illegal bit. Now, the question is, she wasn't eliminated. So she actually rode with an illegal bit. She did this test. The steward found the illegal bit, and maybe she needs to watch the tutorials on marshmallow fluff from Dressage Hub to cover up this nasty little blue tongue issue that we're seeing here. So you can see the tongue waving around, flapping around blue. Oddly enough, she still scored a 7 for this. And this whole ride is riddled with tongue issues. And she still scored a 70%. Now, aside from the scoring issue, let's talk about this illegal bit. So the steward found the illegal bit like they're supposed to. So the bit, it was the maximum length on the shank, and the curb, the port, was higher than legally allowed, and the thickness, it doesn't say whether it was too thick or too thin, the thickness was not allowed, legally allowed either. So the bit was illegal. The steward took it to the judge at sea, and the judge at sea did not eliminate her, and she was therefore allowed to compete in the Grand Prix freestyle with a different bit. Now, as someone who would love to say that dressage is fair and ethical, my question is, who do the rules apply to? Because I feel like if this was not Inessa, so the rules, she would have been eliminated. So where's the bias? Who do the rules apply to? The system's broken because the steward is relying on the judge to uphold the rules. Clearly the judges are not. And if the judge is confident enough in a jury of their peers with 3-4 other judges there, the horse show committee, everybody is supporting this. And then the other part of the article that Euro Dressage talks about is how this, there was a lot of contact issues in this test. So I went back down the internet rabbit hole and I actually found a bunch of pictures. And Astrid's trying to say that this is like a new thing with this horse having contact issues. But a quick trip down the internet rabbit hole will tell you that this horse has consistently had tongue issues. There's plenty of blue tongue pictures from this team. So the question is, how long has she been riding with this illegal bit? How long has she gotten away with it? And she will continue to get away with it because there was no repercussions for the rules not being followed. So the system is broken, and I don't have the answers on how to fix it, but I think it's time that we start talking about the fact that it is broken and does need to be fixed. And, you know, we can start a conversation about some of the issues that we're having and some of the ways to fix it. If you have suggestions, I'm happy to create another video and do a series on things that need to be fixed. How do you fix the corruption that's happening in the sport of dressage as we head into an Olympic year? We're less than 60 days out from Tokyo. So I would love to hear your thoughts. As a rider, this frustrates me to no end because I would like to think that there is an opportunity to have fair and ethical sport.